November 10th is right around the corner, and with it comes a long list of content you want to make sure you have completed before that deadline. In this video, we're going to be starting our Before It's Gone series, and starting with Izanagi's Burden. We're going to be going over the full quest in detail, give you tips and tricks to be aware of along the way, as well as show you guys how you can get the catalyst for Izanagi's Burden. If there's a specific part of the quest you guys are needing help with, there's timestamps down below, be sure to follow them, but there's a lot to cover in this video, so let's go ahead and get started. Hey, what is up guys? Spear Gaming here, helping you get good at Destiny. If you're new here and you want to check out more guides just like this one, remember to click subscribe and ring the bell so you never miss an upload. Today we're talking about Izanagi's Burden. Now, Izanagi's Burden is an exotic sniper rifle, and it's very well known for its insane burst damage. Now, before we actually go into the quest itself, there's a few things I want to point out, that way you're aware of it, because there were some changes from when this quest initially launched. Number one, you're going to need access to the forges. To do this, you want to head to A-1 at the tower in the annex, and you want to make sure you have completed the machine gun quest and actually have access to the forges. The second thing is forges are now on a daily rotation, meaning you can only complete one forge each day, so if you miss one, it might take a few days for you to complete this quest. The forges are always in the same rotation. They go Volunder, Gofanon, Izanami, and then Bergusia in that order. As you're grinding out this quest, you want to make sure you're completing daily and weekly bounties. If you happen to get a rare bounty to drop, and it gets increased chances for each bounty you complete, you want to make sure to not turn this in yet. You're going to need a rare bounty for one of the quest steps, so if you do get it to drop, make sure you hold on to it. The last tip I want to give you guys is any weapons or armor you happen to get from the forges, make sure you save those. The rare bounties that do drop, there's a good portion of them that require you to have a full armor set or a full weapon slots of black armory gear. So you want to make sure to not dismantle any of those weapons or armor until you're fully completed with the Izanagi's Burden quest. Now, to actually start the Izanagi's Burden quest, you're going to need to pick up the Mysterious Box quest from A-1. Basically, you're going to need 4 keys to open the Mysterious Box. To get the keys, you'll actually need to acquire Maximum Temper on each of the 4 forges. What this means is on round 2 of the forge, there's going to be 2 drones that you're going to have to find and destroy. And once you do that, you'll get Maximum Temper. At the end of the forge, once you defeat the boss, there's going to be an additional chest that spawns in the middle. You want to make sure to open that, and that's actually going to give you the key. On screen now, I'm going to show you the location of all the drones in each of the forges, starting with Volunder, moving to Gofanon, then Izanami's, and then Bergusia. For the Volunder, the Gofanon, and the Izanami's, you'll actually get the key once you complete this. However, for the Bergusia one, there's a bit of quest steps you need to complete before you'll actually get the key to drop. To get the fourth and final key to open the box, you'll need an obsidian accelerator, which you get from completing the Bergusia Forge. Head back to A-1 and give it to her, and she's going to give you the Black Armory key mold. Now, the next thing you're going to need to do is gather Watcher's Lenses from the Leviathan. So head to the Leviathan. Once you spawn in, you're going to want to drop down under here, and I'm going to speed it up just a little bit so you guys can see where I'm going. But once you get down to this area, there's actually going to be 6 levers, and you need to pull them in the order that I show right here on screen. You can solo this, however, it is a little bit easier if you have a friend or two. But once you pull the levers in the correct order, in the bottom left of the screen, it's going to say the way is open. Now, once you open up the underbelly, you're going to need to head over underneath, and instead of jumping up the main cannon, you're actually going to go up the stairs, and you'll see this little area by the pipes, which is open. Jump across the pipes, and you're going to get to this part where you hit this lever, and you're going to be able to go up the fan lift. Now, once you get up to the top, you want to make sure you go to the left and into the red room, and this is actually going to lead you straight to the engine room. Once you're in the engine room, you're going to need to destroy these turrets to be able to collect the Watcher lenses. As you start destroying them, enemies will spawn, clear out all the enemies, and then you can destroy the turrets. If you return back to where you were, the door is going to shut behind you and you can reopen it and then rinse and repeat until you get this quest step completed. The next quest step, you're going to have to collect Glimmering Amethyst. Now, the quickest way to get this is you're going to want to do the Lake of Shadows strike. This is one of the fastest strikes you can run. You run it in probably about 5 to 6 minutes if you're speedrunning it, and each time you complete, you'll get 10% Glimmering Amethyst. So run this strike 10 times, and you'll move on to the next quest step. You can also, however, if you want to complete public events as well as collect caches, but running this strike is definitely the fastest way possible. Once you have your Glimmering Amethyst completed, the next step is going to require you to get maximum temper on Bergugia Forge. Now again, this is where the daily forges might mess you up in the rotation of it. You're going to have to get maximum temper on Bergugia to actually get the key to drop, and then you'll actually finally be able to open up the mysterious box. Once you insert all four keys, the box will open and you need to return back to Ada 1 to continue on with the quest. She is then going to give you an unidentified frame, which is where you're going to need to get an obsidian crystal. The way you get that is from the rare bounty. So this is where your rare bounty comes in. You want to make sure that you have this completed, but you have not cashed it in yet. The bounty that I needed, I actually had to regrind the full armor set in order to be able to complete the bounty. So again, make sure you're grinding those bounties dailies and weeklies to try to get this to drop, and hold on to any of the armor or weapons you get from these forges. Now, once you turn in the rare bounty and you're on this quest step, it's going to drop the obsidian crystal. Go ahead and consume it. Once you consume the obsidian crystal for the unidentified frame, you're going to then need to collect ascended glass, which can be found in the Shattered Throne. Now, for the Shattered Throne, you just need to beat the boss. So if you happen to have a friend that can run you through the dungeon super quick, or you happen to be able to find someone that has a boss checkpoint, that'll be super helpful. You don't need to do anything special. All you have to do is defeat Dulin Karu at the end of Shattered Throne to continue with the quest. Next up, you're going to have to complete a special version of the Pyramidian Strike. This is a 750 light activity on Io. It is a world quest, so you can't launch it from the director. I will say though, you do need to make sure you have people that are either on this quest step or have already completed this quest step in order to have them join you for this strike. It does have a few modifiers, including Solar Burn, Heavyweight, Extinguish, as well as it locks your loadout, so make sure you plan accordingly. Once you complete the Pyramidian Strike, the final step is to actually defeat Civix himself. You can launch the mission in the patrol space on the EDZ, just head to the outskirts, and you'll be able to start up the mission. The mission's pretty straightforward, you just go into the Bergugia Forge, and you defeat the boss, and at the end, you'll get the final quest step, which requires you to head back to Ada 1 to pick up your Izanagi's Burden. Now that you have the Izanagi's Burden sniper rifle, the next thing is going to be getting the Izanagi's Burden catalyst. Now, this is a guaranteed drop from Heroic Menagerie, but there's a catch. You do need to have your chalice fully completed. If you look at your chalice, you should see it as masterworked. That means you basically purchased every upgrade you can for the chalice. Again, you want to make sure you farm out your Imperials. Go see Werner on Nessus and pick up his bounties and farm those out. Once you get your chalice fully completed, just do a single run of Heroic Menagerie. Make sure you slot a weapon so you'll get a drop at the chest as well. And once you complete that, it's a guaranteed drop to get the Izanagi's Burden Catalyst. Now, to actually upgrade the catalyst, it is going to take about 500 kills in PvE. I believe this catalyst does progress more in PvP, so if you do happen to take it in there, you can get more progress for it. Now, again, before November 10th, before Beyond Light, if you do complete this catalyst, you want to make sure you apply it and slot it on your weapon to make sure that you have this thing ready in action. Now, the catalyst itself is pretty good. It does increase the damage when you have Honed Edge active. It actually increases it from a x498 multiplier to a x598, which is actually quite a big difference in PvE content. But that is the Izanagi's Burden, the complete quest in detail, tips to be aware of as you're completing this, as well as how you can get the catalyst. Hopefully you guys are able to get this done and knocked out. This gun is definitely worth the grind. But if this guide helped you out, be sure to leave me a like and a comment down below. What are your thoughts on the Izanagi's Burden? Do you have this weapon already, as well as the catalyst? And what are your thoughts on the quest being put into the Destiny Content Vault? If you guys want to catch another guide just like this one, click the link on screen right now. Thank you so much for all the support, and I will see you guys in the next video.